Hey guys, welcome to a brand new series of Gems of Goa. I'm Alicia Fernandez and I'm on this unique journey of traveling and visiting different places and finding the true gems of the soil. Yes, I have with me in this episode the young, the dynamic, the enthusiastic, the ever smiling, the bubbly, the exotic, none other than Amanda Vaz. Hi Amanda, welcome to Prime TV.
Thank you so much for having me.
So, what's the delay? Let's go and talk to her and have this wonderful conversation about her journey only on Prime.
Dio bara dees tum. Mujhe naam Amanda Vaz. Ha utra varshache bhartiya. Mujhe sobit ani mankulya goinche kirin.
Maka painting, craft, music ani dance karpa khupus avatta. Mujhe shikshana khao, bachelor's degree in biotechnology shikta. हावे गोयांग बास्केटबॉलांग आणि शॉटपुटांग प्रदर्शित केला. हालीच हावे बीच क्रिंग प्रोजेक्टांत भाग घेतला, जसो प्रतिनिधी जावन आसा ॲडवोकेट अफरोज शाह. ह्या जिवितांत म्हजो एकूच हेतू, आम्ही एकूच पावट जियेता आणि ह्या जिवितांत अर्थ दिवपाक हांव सदांच उर्बे बरीत आणि माये मोगान दुसऱ्याची सेवा करपाक सोदतां.
Well, so now we have with us none other than the most beautiful and talented Amanda Vaz. Hello Amanda, welcome to Prime TV.
Thank you so much for having me on your show.
So Amanda, tell us about the experience being the first runner-up at the TGPC.
It was amazing. Actually, I love representing myself and my state at a national pageant. It has always been a dream, especially when I just started my pageant journey in January of 2019, that is this year itself. I'm so glad that I had the support and the love that I could get this far and represent my state, I hope beautifully, at the national pageant.
Definitely, there's no doubt in that.
Thank you.
So what is this pageant all about, like TGPC? Like a lot of people were not aware about it. So like tell us more about the pageant.
The pageant breaks stereotypes mm-hmm. in every possible way. There is no height criteria, there's no way a girl should look, there are no racial boundaries or anything. It's based only upon the way you want to grow mm-hmm. and the way you transform yourself from the first day to the last day. And that's about how amazing it is, because it's all about discovering yourself, because that is what life is about.
I feel like there are a lot of contestants who are a part of this particular pageant. So like how did you stand out maybe from all of them?
There were 1,800 applicants. And
that's a huge number.
Exactly. And there were 51 contestants who got shortlisted. Mm-hmm. And from that, I think I just gave it my best. I just blocked everything out. Mm-hmm. And I said, Amanda, let's do it. And that's how I reached the top three. The pageant works in levels, mm-hmm. so from 51 you have top 20, and from top 20 you have top 10. And I was glad to be selected as the elite choice. So mm-hmm. what that exactly means is that I was selected based on my merit, based on my walk around, mm-hmm. My evening gown. And there's this elite panel jury, mm-hmm. and they thought that I was the best contestant and I had the highest score for mm-hmm. my walk video, and that got me a direct entry into the top 10.
Oh,
and from that it was top 6 mm-hmm. and then top 3.
Oh, and that's how you have got a pageant and you won it.
Yeah, that's already how I evolved, and I kept learning because we had amazing, we had talented mentors.
Mm-hmm.
And these mentors, they know everything. Mm-hmm. Like they know how to break a girl.
So was it in Goa itself that you got to do this, or was it like you had to move somewhere else?
The thing about this pageant, it is completely online. Mm-hmm. It's kind of the world's first online pageant, and mm-hmm. it is definitely worth it because there's very limited stuff that you can do online and change a girl mm-hmm. through WhatsApp video calls and through messages and videos.
Mm-hmm.
But TGPC knows where exactly to train a girl and what to change in the girl. Not change about
No,
you.
But in the sense like when you got into this particular pageant, you must be like a little bit nervous at the same time excited also, because it's something different and
yeah.
something that nobody heard of.
Yeah.
So this is something like very distinctive in its kind.
Yeah.
So when you got into it, how was the experience from your end? Like, you know, a Goan girl getting into something like this where there are 1,000+ contestants.
I was very excited. I was very confident about myself because I had my parents' support.
Mm-hmm.
I had my family. I had very understanding and encouraging friends. And this is a pageant is online. I can do it from the convenience of my home. I don't have to move anywhere. So I was very relaxed, you could say. And I had love pouring in from all the sides. When you have so much of positivity, there's nothing that can go wrong.
Yeah, I had seen a video of yours which you had done specially about planting trees.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, so tell us more about that. How was that entire idea that you conceptualized, and was it your own, and or how did you got inspired by someone? How was it all about?
I have always been inclined towards nature and planting trees. But I think I got very involved this year. And about my project, it's called Green Goals because Green Goals directly speaks about what goes on in the project. And this year we planted 120 trees along with my college. My college, Parvati Bhai Chowdhury College, is very supportive. My principal was always there for me. He planted the first tree.
Oh, wow.
We had 80 volunteers that turned up from college. And that
so did you all do it like in a particular area which was marked by all, or like you did it like in general to different places?
My principal asked me, Where do you want to plant trees?
Exactly.
It's your college.
Oh.
And I said, wow, thank you for giving me that opportunity and saying that. That really means a lot. They did tell us where they specifically want trees, and I planted the trees where I wanted because there are some spots in college that can get really hot. So I wanted to plant trees. Maybe in some years I'll get to see
the shade.
Blooming trees. Yeah, and then we planted trees at my residence. We already have a lot of trees, but I still wanted to add as many as I can, and then we planted some in the city of Margao. And I was lucky enough to get, for my project, to get a recognition from the former Chief Minister of Goa.
Oh, that's lovely.
Yes.
Indeed, when you see something like this, it's like something which is very inspiring, and very at the same time, it's very something which you do it with the grassroots level, considering the nature. So the entire idea concept is beautiful. You recently walked at Philo Martens as a showstopper
for International Fashion Week.
So I want to know more about that. But before that, we'll slip into a short break and we'll be right back.
This is Inform Media Prime Slot Network. And you're watching Prime. Your voice, your channel.
Welcome back. I'm in conversation with Amanda Vaz. So Amanda, tell us about your experience at the International Fashion Week.
Oh, thank you so much for asking. Since I won the first runner-up of India's Miss DGPC, I had the golden opportunity to walk the ramp as a showstopper for Philo Martens at International Fashion Week, and it was more than I could ever expect. I wore this beautiful golden dress and I walked with a crown. I was all dazzled in gold and embellished, you could say. And surprisingly, I also got a feature. I got features on a magazine and on newspaper, and that took me by surprise.
Exactly. So life must have definitely changed ever since this pageant. So
life
how did it change?
Life changed drastically. I feel like my voice was being heard, and people took the time to understand me, like they always did, but people started listening to me and my opinions and admiring me for the person that I am, and I feel so proud of myself now.
Exactly.
I hope my parents are too.
Exactly.
And Goa.
No, but when you see this entire scenario, you feel like there are many people who have just like, you know, they come through pageants, they win a lot of pageants, but they do not get the recognition that they are supposed to get. So what is your take about it? Like, you know, how do you want people to know about it more?
I think that a person makes a pageant equally as to how a pageant makes a person.
Correct.
We see so many amazing talents at budding pageants, and they just know how to handle themselves. When they're confident about themselves, when they keep working hard, they keep hustling, that's when they make a mark for themselves. We had, for example, the Miss World, Priyanka Chopra.
Exactly.
She kept working hard, and that's what I wish to do. I keep working hard, never stay stagnant, attitude, always keep going. And that's how you, you know, engage with people, and that's how you win the hearts of people, I think.
No doubt, definitely, that is there only. So you must be having somebody like a role model or somebody that you look up to. So who would you look up to?
I look up to Miss Earth India 2019, Dr. Tejaswini Manogna, because she is such a humble person. She is a yoga practitioner. Mm-hmm. She is an amazing Bharatanatyam dancer. I think she has won Miss Talented for every pageant that she has gone for. Mm-hmm. She has won India's Best Cadet. Mm-hmm. She is just a gem of a person, and she's a doctor. What mm-hmm. can you ask for? She's like a combination of, she's like the best combination that you could find in a person.
Definitely.
I really aspire to, you know, be like her or walk in her footsteps, because she also has similar advocacies when it comes mm-hmm. to environment. She is into mass tree plantation. She's a motivational speaker and she enlightens youth. So if I could meet her, I would definitely, you know, ask her to come plant trees with me.
In Goa itself.
Yeah, in Goa, yes.
So when we see this entire picture of, you know, like you being the Miss TGPC.
Yes.
So when you had ever imagined that, you know, when this entire scenario took place in your life, you were like a normal girl.
Yeah, just last year. Yeah. I didn't even know anything about pageants.
Exactly. So like did you like, you know, transform yourself from like, you know, a normal school going girl who maybe likes football, basketball. So like how was that transformation? Like now then directly from sneakers maybe to high heels.
I am so tall. I am 6 feet. I never had this urge of wearing high heels, and if I did, I would just be standing
in one place.
Yeah, I would be standing in one place because I'd feel really awkward walking in heels, and I was never really comfortable in heels. And my first pageant was by chance, actually.
Okay.
My mom walked into the designer's showroom.
Uh-huh.
We had a meeting with one of my mentors.
Mm-hmm.
And my mom was like, so is this the pageant? And the organizer says yes. And my mom's like, how much do I pay and everything? And I'm like, mom, we didn't discuss about this. I didn't know it was a pageant. I thought it was a fashion show. And I was freaking out, like, I have never walked in heels, mom, what did you sign me up for? And my mom is like, you know, just try it out.
Mm.
I think you can do it. It's just going to make you more confident, expose you to a lot of people, and see, you're going to be so graceful by the end of it. You're going to transform, just believe me and go for it. And I was like, mom, I was so skeptical about it. But after my training with Stella Miss Goa, I really saw the change. And from Jan 2019 till now, I have seen, I think I've transformed, you know, into a completely different person.
A huge transformation from there.
Yeah, and that's what I think pageants have done for me. And this is only possible because I had the Stellar family.
Mm-hmm.
That is the first pageant. And I had amazing mentors who always told me to believe in myself.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So you must be like, you know, very much enthusiastic when it comes to dancing as well, because yeah. I heard that, you know, you're a very good dancer as well.
Oh, thank you.
Tell us about that as well. In your talent round, you must have definitely performed something.
For my TGPC talent round, I have done 4 years of classical Bharatanatyam.
Oh, wow.
And I wish to do more when I have the time. But for my TGPC talent round, I also am an artist. I do paper costumes.
Oh.
So I felt really sick. I felt really sick during the TGPC days, and I had a bad sore throat and a bad headache. So I couldn't get myself to dance because it would just make the condition worse. So I decided to go with paper costumes.
Oh.
And the jury loved it.
Mm-hmm.
And they were like, wow, this is something unique and we've never seen something like this. And I was really glad that I could bring something new to the table.
Definitely something very different than the usual one. Usually it's just like the talent round, but you have the talent as well as this.
Thank you.
We are slipping into a short break right now. On the other side, we're going to do the rapid fire round, so stay tuned.
This is InfoMedia Prime Slot Network, and you're watching Prime, your voice, your channel.
Okay, welcome back. We are in conversation with Amanda Vaz with regard to her journey at the pageant she recently represented Goa at. So, Amanda, tell us about what do you feel about beauty? How do you define beauty?
I think beauty lies within a person's soul. It is 10% the way you present yourself, and 90% is all within your confidence, the way you speak to people, your energy. And definitely the way you interact with people, engagement is a key, because everybody likes a person who's smiling and who likes to talk to others, who makes the other person feel very warm and cozy.
Exactly. No, but when you see this entire concept of this beauty pageants, like they are like recently picking up. Earlier, this culture of beauty pageants was not like in news. And a lot of people used to not, you know, be in favor of it. Mm-hmm. But today, like, you know, parents are supporting their children with regard to this. So tell us about your take on that.
That's the beauty of evolution, even when it comes to pageantry. Pageantry is trying to be more inclusive now. It's all about empowering women. You have a mind of your own. You can say whatever you feel like. And my parents are very supportive about it because they trust me. And they think that I have the capabilities of representing my nation because they know I'm very patriotic. I've represented my country. The student exchange program actually has represented our country at Japan. I performed the Ganesh Vandana, that is one form of dance in Bharatanatyam, in Japan, in front of the Japanese students, teachers, and the audience.
Oh, that's lovely.
Yes. So I really found that touch with my culture, and I think I can push it forward in as many platforms that I can.
Definitely, there's no doubt in that. You must be like, you know, when you consider this entire concept, there must be something that which you would prefer to be like, you know, a change in the society. So what is that one aim of yours when it comes to, you know, doing something different in the society? What is your take on that?
It would just be representing myself, because as I walk on the stage, I think I'm breaking several stereotypes myself. So I would request maybe more girls to participate in pageants and to show the inner side that, you know, they would always be shy to show, because then you're bringing something new to the table, you're showing people something unique about you, and that's going to be another girl looking up to you.
Definitely, that's something
that you're going to be a role model.
Definitely,
and that's like one of the best feelings ever,
no doubt in that. Okay, so let's head into our rapid fire round.
Right.
So just brace yourself. Are you ready for it?
Yes.
Okay, so let's get started. If you woke up as the following people, what would you do? Minister of Environment.
Plant more trees.
Priyanka Chopra.
Try on the Miss World crown.
Sushmita Sen.
Try the Miss Universe crown.
Me.
I would host more beauty pageant interviews.
Okay, so what do you have that none of your contemporary have?
Sorry?
What do you have that none of your contemporary have?
A smile.
Okay, one talent which you are secretly proud of?
singing.
Okay. So nobody knows about it that you sing.
Please don't make me sing.
No, you can try. We'll try it after this rapid fire round.
I like singing Christmas carols.
Oh, okay.
In the shower.
Okay. One secret no one knows.
That.
Some deep down secret.
Oh my god. That. Oh my god.
Has to be quickly.
That I have probably gone. No, I don't know.
You don't want to say it because your parents will be watching this.
No, I really can't think of a secret because I'm an open book. I'm an open book. So
okay, so I'll give you that for you. One film you wish to star in?
Sanjay Leela Bhansali's films.
Okay. What is your biggest addiction?
Oh my god, I think it's overrated by my phone.
By the phone?
Yeah, my social media.
Oh, by social media,
I
okay.
I have to keep checking it.
Okay, rank the following. Salman, Shah Rukh, Karan, Siddharth.
Shah Rukh, amazing English. Salman, Siddharth, and we had the
Karan.
Okay.
And Priyanka, Sushmita, Deepika, or Shamita.
Oh my god, they're all amazing. I love watching the interview, so it has to go to Sushmita.
Okay.
Priyanka, Deepika. I'm so sorry, but I'm so sorry that I got to keep the beauty pageants first. And then.
Yes. Okay, I think you did pretty well in your
rapid fire. Thank you.
So yes, tell us something more about now, since we are heading towards the almost the end of this particular interview. Tell us more about what would you like to give out your message to the people of Goa, to the young girls who are looking up to you.
I would like to say that you are the creator of your own destiny. So believe in yourself and plan out your goals. Don't ever listen to what other people have to say unless it is constructive for you, and just go live your dream.
Exactly. You just have to go and live your dream, most importantly. Before you know, we just wind up in this particular interview, what is the next course of action? Like, what is the next future goals of yours? to do? What is your future plans, basically?
When I won India's Miss TGPC, I always ask myself that question, and now I'm here. Mm-hmm. So life takes me by surprise, and I'm just going to leave it up to God's vision for me, mm-hmm. and whatever time has to offer me.
Yes, so that was Amanda. Thank you so much for taking time off and talking to us.
Thank you so much
and
for
coming
me.
Here in the studio.
Of course.
Yes, so this is the very first interview that she has given, and I think she did a very pretty amazing job. So do let us know what you all think about this particular interview, what you feel about this gem that Goa has produced. And yes, this is me, Alicia Fernandez.
Can I say bye?
Yeah, please.
Bye.
Okay, so on that note, this is me, Alicia Fernandez, signing off from Gems of Goa, and keep watching Prime TV for more news and updates.